And hello, welcome to our presentation. I'm Natalia.
I'm Darius.
I'm Georgia.
I'm Mommy Lanto.
And today we're going to present to you our co-branded product and why we think it will be a great success within the chocolate spread market. We are going to do this by providing you with an in-depth analysis of our two chosen brands and then go on to highlight why we think our co-brand will be set aside from the competition.
Ferrero is the parent company of Nutella, which is our chosen product. It's been established in 1946 in Italy. Between the years of 2013 and 2014, they generated a turnover of £7.5 billion. They employ over 34,000 people across 53 different countries. They possess 20 production plants and 9 agricultural companies around the world. The products are sold worldwide in more than 160 countries, and it's clear to say that their success made them cultural icons of the chocolates. Ferrero's and Nutella CSR is published every year on their website. They endorse educational care and welfare for children. They actively support physical activity programs which help to tackle obesity amongst young children and teenagers. And they demonstrate all those factors through sustainable sourcing of raw materials, protection of the environment and fight against Ferrero's group values include innovation, creativity, quality and freshness, and responsibility and respect. They display these values through their research and development, strict sourcing policy, and manufacturing, as well as sustainable agriculture.
Moving on its social responsibilities, they also are a member of the World Cocoa Foundation, and they're trying to attain about 100% sustainable certified cocoa. So we've chosen Nutella as our sub-brand, and the parent company being Ferrero was also created in 1946, and it already enjoys 28.4% volume share of the sweet spread sector, and an increase of 6% last year, beating Cadbury Smooth and Mars Milky Way. The bulk of the market is also taken by the Ferrero Rocher company and the other three big companies. 250,000 tons of Nutella are sold in 75 countries each year, and 9 global factories, 5 in Europe, 1 in Russia, 1 in North America, 2 in South America, and one in Australia.
So to show our customers where our sub-brand is placed in the current market, we've made a perceptual map in terms of positioning for quality and price. Compared to other competitors, Nutella is placed here, which is of a medium to high price and a high quality. And this complements our co-brand because our co-brand product will be placed a bit higher than this in an even more premium position.
This is a segmentation of Nutella. The demographic of Nutella targets children and families, middle class income, women and mothers to be specific. The behavioral aspect of the segmentation map is a healthy breakfast. It's a nostalgia brand and brand loyalty, and it's high volume usage.
So in the psychographic segment, we have indulgent, naughty snack, and family breakfast. These are the three main things that influences buyers to purchase Nutella. And geographic wise, it's usually in urban and rural areas, and it's currently spread in 172 countries worldwide.
So these are the SWOT analysis for Nutella. Strengths include a well-established brand, a wide product range, such as Be Ready, Nutella Go and Kinder Surprise. It's a niche market, so it's a breakfast spread aimed at families, a high quality product and effective advertising with the slogan Spread It Happy. Weaknesses include unhealthiness, so it contains 45% of sugar. It's expensive, the raw materials are expensive to import, and it has a high activity of palm oil, which is again unhealthy. On the other hand, the opportunities of co-branding with another company include exploring a new market segment, so a healthier product, which is our aim. Maximising sales by entering a new market segment and substituting sugar with an alternative sweetener, which would be stevia, because that's what consumers want. And finally, threats include hazelnut shortage in Argentina and parts of Africa, Brexit, which caused high import costs and weaker currency, the sugar tax, which has also made it more expensive for the products we made, decrease in disposable income due to the rise of interest rates in the UK, and shrinkflation, which affects the size of the product.
When considering the effects of Brexit that's had on consumer confidence, we can see that in November it decreased. However, looking at statistics from Keynote in 2016, Nutella is deemed to be very essential in many households, even during times of financial stability, which is why we have chosen it as our sub-brand. So in the next few slides, we're going to give you an overview of the sweet and savoury spreads industry, which will convince you why we think picking green and blacks to co-brand with Nutella was the right choice. So firstly, when looking at the sweet and savoury spreads market, according to Keynote 2016, we can see that the market was valued at 1.17 billion, showing a growth of 3.4% from the previous year and an impressive increase of 16.8% since 2010. Despite volumes remaining flat due to the increased cost of raw materials such as nuts, Mintel forecast an overall growth of 19% in the overall sweet and savoury spreads market by 2018. The British spreads market is deemed to be highly saturated, which gives us opportunities for growth in smaller subsectors in this market, such as the organic dark spreads.
Mintel's market analysis of the sweet savoury spreads market shows that Ferrero owns roughly about 36% of the market share, which makes them one of the strongest market leaders.
Yeah, Mintel's global food and drink trends for 2018. Consumers are becoming increasingly concerned about the amount of sugar in their food. 62% to be precise, and 56% say they're actively taking steps to limit or reduce the sugar and opting for low in sugar food instead. They also look at ethically and environmentally sourced foods. This is the perfect opportunity to introduce a new sweet spreads into the market, which possesses all of these qualities. To ensure that our new co-branded product fits in with current food trends, so that we are able to meet the consumer's needs and wants. Research has shown from Cargill 2018 that consumers are demanding premium, healthy products which are sustainably and ethically sourced.
We've decided to choose Green and Black's dark chocolate as our co-brand with Nutella, and now I'm going to tell you why. It's important to look at the current demand for dark chocolate in the UK and how this will impact our sales. The Centre for Promotion of Imports from Developing Countries said that in their report last year, high quality and fine flavoured cocoa is the fastest growing segment in the chocolate market. And Europe currently accounts for around 45% of dark chocolate consumption, which is expected to grow at an annual rate of over 8% by next year. European consumers are also increasingly concerned about health and well-being, and dark chocolate also includes health benefits such as antioxidants and flavonoids. These lower blood pressure, improve blood vessel health, and improve cholesterol. Why in particularly Green and Blacks? Well, basically, this company was started off as a small family business, and it was run by a man called Craig Sams, who was a vegetarian and owned an organic macrobiotic restaurant in London. He also co-founded the organic food company Whole Earth. Him and his wife Jo then discovered the staple dark chocolate, and it went on to become the famous Green and Black chocolate bar that we all know today. One of the main reasons we chose Green and Black for our co-brand is because of their active involvement in corporate social responsibility. They have a good reputation for their green part, their brand name, hence the name Green and Blacks. And it was formed from the fact that their cocoa sourcing is fair trade and highly ethical. Green and Black's organic chocolate collection is fair trade approved. The Velvet Collection is also investing $400 million by 2022 to empower 200,000 cocoa farmers around the world. Mondelez International, who now own Green and Blacks, are now the world's largest buyer of fair trade certified cocoa, and this is the Coco Life brand. Nadella's International, which are now owners of Green and Blacks, are now the world's largest buyer of certified fair trade cocoa. They are involved in a project called Coco Life, which has been implemented to design the interventions that lift people out of poverty and establish cocoa communities as desirable places to live. This is our perceptual map for market positioning for Green and Blacks. As you can see, we've put the other competitors on the map as well, so we can clearly define where Green and Blacks stand against its chocolate competitors. So in terms of quality and price, Green and Blacks is just above mint chocolate at a higher price but higher quality, and this is the luxury premium positioning that we want to create for a superior brand. So this is our SWOT analysis for Green and Blacks. For strengths, obviously we've listed that they are ethical and highly involved in fair trade. They only source natural ingredients, so raw cane sugar, and they're palm oil free. They have high quality dark chocolate, which means high customer satisfaction. They have nutritional values such as antioxidants. And the independent states, their growth levels hit 60 to 70%, and they are...
A few of the weaknesses of Green and Black's products are that they are highly priced. However, this is reflected in their quality and the premium positioning that it has in the confectionery market. It is a niche market product, however, it specialises to a specific target audience, so it overcomes that barrier. And lastly, the lack of advertising presence for Green and Blacks is another weakness. However, this is why we've decided to co-brand it with Nutella, which offers like high advertising.
Opportunities include expanding globally in countries such as United States, Canada, and Australia. Another one would be the range of product types and flavours, which is constantly expanding due to new innovations by the company. And finally, advertising opportunities are going to increase as well with the promotion of the importance of ethically sourced goods.
Cadbury acquired Green and Blacks, and there might be an unsteady relationship between the brands. There's a rising public health concern by the government and rising cocoa import prices.
Okay, now we would like to introduce you our new co-branded product, which is Nutella with Green and Blacks, which has 85% dark chocolate, high in antioxidants, low in palm oil, and using an artificial sweetener, stevia, instead of sugar, and also it's ethically sourced, which targets our customers. So before going along with our idea, it was important to assess the risks and benefits of co-branding. So some of the benefits are that able to establish credibility. Co-branding two well-established brands will not only appeal to a whole new market segment, but reduce the amount of money spent on marketing, which in return will boost our long-term profits. On the other hand, possible risks involve confusion about the significance of our new product, which would mean sales may take a while to pick up. However, this will not be a problem for our product, because we have designed our product around the needs and wants of current consumer preferences.
So for our co-brand, we've decided to create a perceptual map in terms of nutrition and ethical standards. Compared to Tesco, Value and Sunpat spreads, our Green and Black's Nutella is placed high up here for high nutrition and high ethical standards next to a well-known organic spread brand.
Segmentation of our co-brand. The demographic will be targeting adults aged 35 to 65, more specifically women in middle high class income. The psychographic would be high earners, easily persuaded, disposable income, and we'll be aiming for a low volume usage. For the behavioristic variable, impulse buyers, busy working lifestyle, indulgent yet healthy eaters. For the geographic variable, we're going to be targeting urban and rural areas and focusing mainly in the United
States. So this is our SWOT analysis for our kind of brand. In terms of strengths, obviously it's the integration of two well-established brands in the chocolate market, Nutella and Green and Blacks. This will allow us a smoother entry into the chocolate market because of brand loyalty. The green and black dark chocolate links to current consumer food trends, so dark chocolate offers health benefits such as high in antioxidants. In terms of weaknesses, it will be premium priced, but this will be overcome through the middle class target audience and promised quality and health benefits of product, like I just mentioned. There could be some weaknesses such as customers aren't willing to try the new product and that it's a niche market.
Opportunities to promote more, example, adverts, PR, celebrity endorsements, etc. To expand the business, like different flavors, increase multi-channels, like become available online and in supermarkets. Some of the threats would be the competitors, like there might be a cheaper dark chocolate spread as opposed to ours. The economy changes, so the import prices of cocoa. Global shortage of cocoa by 2020 due to increase.
This is our pistol analysis for our co-brand. So in terms of political, the UK government implemented a childhood obesity plan for action that was implemented last year, 2017. Basically, this stresses the rising public health concerns by the UK government. Also, Brexit, due to the UK leaving the EU, import costs on raw materials on products is going to be higher. This therefore means that firms have to pay more to manufacture their products.
In terms of the economic aspect of Festool, the interest rates have increased in the UK, which therefore have affected the disposable income of people living in the UK in a bad way, as people cannot spend as much as they used to. And another factor is the saturated market, so the big players in the market are the ones getting the most market share opportunity for the growth.
In terms of social, Sweet Spreads have helped the impact of an ongoing negative press coverage related to sugar. In fact, their high sugar content acts as a purchase barrier for a large minority of 39% of users. Meanwhile, low in sugar is amongst the top three attributes Sweet Spread shoppers express interest in. Declining consumption of pre-packed bread means that our co-brand will be able to target an older generation who'd enjoy the sweet spread as a snack with some fruit, possibly strawberries or rice cakes.
For technology, most of the industrial chocolate is manufactured conventionally from the cocoa mass, and it goes through a variable amount of steps, mixing, grinding, and conjuring. There are opportunities for research and development at each of the stages, which can give our product a competitive edge over our other competitors. The chocolate industry also follows a current trend in like the various industries, which is an experiencing trend towards globalization. This global culture convergence is caused largely by the rapid technology advancement in the information technology communication industry, whereby the usage of internet, mobile, e-business, satellite TV, and other multi-country media are emerging and growing.
So as of April the 6th in the UK, there will be a sugar tax implemented only on sugary drinks. However, this will not affect our chocolate because it's low in sugar as it is anyway.
So due to Brexit, the British pound has dropped on the currency exchange market, which therefore means importing and exporting goods is going to become a bit more expensive.
In terms of environmental, there are increasing concerns of sustainable source of raw materials such as palm oil. We've tackled this problem because our new product is ethically sourced and we're replacing palm oil with sunflower.
So our target market would be a niche market, concentrating on marketing efforts on small, specific, but well-defined segments of the population. We're targeting 35 to 60 year olds, specifically women in middle high household incomes with a health and conscious mind.
To create our co-branded product, the promotional mix is an essential factor to make sure that we're attracting our buyers. We decided that public relations will be the most useful to engage our target audience, as this is a wide platform that can cover many different aspects of social media. For example, newspaper or magazine features. These features will not only include an attractive image of our product, but contain useful information that will inform older readers of the health benefits of dark chocolate. For magazines, they will feature in women's or health magazines with appealing images and persuasive info, for example, less sugar, more organic. The PR team can also organise promotional events, so for example, Fair Healthy in London is a health food festival, to gain more exposure. Also, we can advertise through social media platforms such as Facebook, as this is the most commonly used by our target audience, which is middle-aged to older people. Public relations is cost effective, so we're not spending loads of money on TV advertising, and can also promote positive consumer attitudes towards purchasing our brand, as we have more control over what our audience are seeing. We may also promote our co-branding product through the use of TV advertising, so this will be shown on evening times from 6 to 10pm to target the older audience that are watching TV around that time, channels such as BBC and Channel. So for the promotional mix, it's essential to understand the ad model to grab the attention of our buyers, their interest, desire and action to buy the product. So for attention, we will grab the consumer's attention through our attractive brand image through TV advertising and magazine features. And they'll be interested in green and black Nutella from the factual information from the PR coverage about the nutritional information and health benefits. Their desire to buy the product will come from the emotional connection that Green and Black's chocolate is fair trade and ethically sourced, and that the health benefits offer something different in the chocolate spread market. The action to buy the product will come from the fact that Green and Black's Nutella will be widely available in stores such as Waitrose, M&S, Holland & Barrett and selected supermarkets. These customers for these stores match our target audience, middle class, organic and health conscious. Also, our psychological pricing strategy at $3.49 will encourage buyers to
use Porter's five forces to analyse our competitive environment. We have established five main chocolate, dark chocolate spread brands that may pose as a threat. These range from supermarkets owned brands such as Tesco's and Morrison's, and more premium brands like Biona. We've decided to price our product using a premium pricing strategy, also known as price skimming. We believe that setting a high price for our co-branded product is reflected within the quality of it. We also decided to use psychological pricing strategy at $3.49 to trick the consumers to think that they are getting a good deal. In place, we decided to use indirect channel distribution, also selective distribution, because we want our product to be available in high-end stores such as Holland & Barrett's, Waitrose, Sainsbury's and Tesco's. We believe that we choose selective distribution because we want to sell it in a more geographically concentrated areas such as just in the UK. And we believe that we will have greater control over our marketing our product. So to conclude, this is why we believe that our co-brand will be successful within the UK spreads market. Both brands are well established, well known and popular amongst users and buyers within the age range of our target audience. It's a brand new product in the market.
And it is an ethical, organic, UK-based company which will attract older, health-conscious UK buyers. And Green & Black's Nutella is positioned as a premium product on the market which will help increase our sales.
Combating issues regarding sugar and content. The taste is unique, combining dark chocolate and Nutella's distinct taste.
As well as that, the spread is versatile. And our promotion of the new product will encourage buyers to through the AWS.
Thank you for watching.
And we hope we've given you enough reason for you to invest in our co-brand.